joy, give glory to God. Lift up your hearts and sing. Let all creation tell of his name. Praise him forevermore. Blessed are you, God of our fathers. Glory and praise forevermore. Blessed your great and glorious holy name. Glory and praise forevermore. Ring out your joy, give glory to God. Lift up your hearts and sing. Let all creation tell of his name. Praise him forevermore.
This Mass is offered for the following intentions: wedding anniversary blessings for Afra and Jude Trinidad, Demetra and Martin, first birthday blessings for Mitchell Babu Rodericks, birthday blessings for Sharon D'Souza, Urmila Simur, Dr. Sharon Seru, Denzel Fernandez, Brittany, James Das, McKeven Pereira, Juliana D'Souza, Carissa Trinidad, Marilia Fernandez, Afra Trinidad, Sharon Zenden Rasalkar, Lisa Fernandez, good health and well-being of Trinidad, Suarez and Correa families, Craig, Bianca and Aiden Cairo, birthday remembrance of Sandra D'Souza, and blessings for the D'Souza family, wedding anniversary remembrance for Neville and Jennifer Meneses, for the souls of Violet Rocky Machado, first death anniversary, Stanley Almeida, Donald D'Souza, and Tony D'Cruz, Edward and Rosemary Lopez, Everest Pereira, Charles and Lily Fernandez, Joseph Austin Pereira, Hilary Cornelio, Juano Crasto, Hector Crasto, Risa Silveria, Kenneth Fernandez, Raymond Pereira, Joyce and Doris D'Souza, and deceased members of D'Souza family, Augustine Borges, Ruby Francis Blaze, and members of the Blaze family, Ignatius, Mary and Thomas Barrow, Percy Rodericks. We also pray for all those who celebrate their birthdays, anniversaries, and are praying for an important intention today. All together, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the priceless communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today the church celebrates the feast of Saint Teresa of Avila, Virgin and Doctor. To celebrate the sacred mysteries of this Eucharist in a worthy manner, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord's pardon and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
O God, who through your Spirit raised up Saint Teresa of Jesus to show the Church the way to seek perfection, grant that we may always be nourished by the food of our heavenly teaching and fired with longing for true holiness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brethren, what then shall we say was gained by Abraham, our forefather, according to the flesh? For if Abraham was justified by works, he has something to boast about, but not before God. For what does the scripture say? Abraham believed God, and it was counted to him as righteousness. Now, to the one who works his wages are not counted as a gift, but as his due. And to the one who does not work, but believes in him who justifies the ungodly, his faith is counted as righteousness. Just as David also speaks of the blessings of the one to whom God counts righteousness apart from works. Blessed are those whose lawless deeds are forgiven and whose sins are covered. Blessed is the man against whom the Lord will not count his sin. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response to the psalm is, you are a hiding place for me. You surround me with cries of deliverance. Kindly listen to the tune.
You are a hiding place for me. You surround me with cries of deliverance.
Together.
You are a hiding place for me. You surround me with cries of deliverance.
Blessed is he whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is remitted. Blessed is the man to whom the Lord imputes no guilt, in whose spirit is no guile.
You are a hiding place for me. You surround me with cries of deliverance.
To you I have acknowledged my sin, my guilt I did not hide. I said, I will confess my transgression to the Lord, and you have forgiven the guilt of my sin.
Altogether,
you are a hiding place for me. You surround me with cries of deliverance. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
May your merciful love be upon us as we hope in you, O Lord.
At that time, when so many thousands of the people had gathered together that they were trampling one another, Jesus began to say to his disciples first, "Beware of the leaven of the Pharisees, which is hypocrisy. Nothing is covered up that will not be revealed, or hidden that will not be known. Therefore, whatever you have said in the dark shall be heard in the light, and what you have whispered in private rooms shall be proclaimed on the housetops. I tell you, my friends, do not fear those who kill the body, and after that have nothing more that they can do. But I will warn you whom to fear. Fear him who, after he has killed, has authority to cast into hell. Yes, I tell you, fear him. Are not five sparrows sold for 2 pennies? And not one of them is forgotten before God. Why, even the hairs of your head are all numbered. Fear not, you are of more value than many sparrows." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters, today as we celebrate the feast of Saint Teresa of Avila, the Church tells us that Saint Teresa her heart was totally dedicated and devoted to God. She was a woman of prayer, of discipline and compassion. She was instrumental in setting more than half a dozen monasteries all over. She traveled extensively, she wrote extensively, and she also fought to renew and reform the church. And finally, my dear brothers and sisters, Saint Teresa of Avila had a very deep, intimate, personal relationship with Jesus because she spoke openly and honestly to him. In the gospel today, Jesus teaches his disciples not to fear. He says, "Do not fear, be fearless." God watches over his disciples. We are significant before God. God watches over us. Let us stay faithful. Let us remain faithful to Jesus and to his promises to each one of us. Let us pray at this Eucharist the grace to trust and believe, like Saint Teresa, that God loves us much more than we can ever imagine. Amen.
These gifts of bread and wine, change not these temples into your flesh and blood. Come to the banquet and share the meal divine. Peace, love is offered and
pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
May our offerings, O Lord, be acceptable to your majesty, to whom the devoted service of Saint Teresa was pleasing in such great measure. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promise in the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we agree.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald Gracious, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
O Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my home, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Our act of spiritual communion. My Jesus.
My Jesus.
I believe that you are present,
that you are present
in the most holy sacrament.
In the most holy sacrament.
I love you
above all things
and I desire
to receive you
into my soul since I cannot at this moment
receive you sacramentally
Come at least spiritually
into my heart.
I embrace you
as if you are already there
and unite myself
wholly to you.
Never permit me
to be separated from you.
Amen.
Shepherd of my soul, I give you full control. Wherever you may lead, I will follow. I have made the choice to listen to your voice. Wherever you may lead, I will go. Or by a gentle stream, the shepherd of my soul is by my side. Should I face a mighty mountain or a valley dark and deep, the shepherd of my soul will be my guide.
For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion, Abba, Father, have mercy on us, save us from the virus. For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion,
Abba, Father, have mercy on us, save us from the virus.
For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion,
Abba, Father, have mercy on us, and save us from the virus.
For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion,
Abba, Father, have mercy on us, and save us from the virus.
For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion,
Abba, Father, have mercy on us, and save us from the virus.
Grant, O Lord our God, that your obedient family, whom you have fed with the bread of heaven, may follow the example of Saint Teresa and rejoice to sing of your mercies for all eternity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Our Lady of Mount Carmel,
pray for us.
You have everything when you have Christ. You have everything when you have Christ. You are filled with God through your union with Christ. He is the highest ruler with authority over every other part. He is the highest ruler You have everything when you have Christ. You are filled with God through your union with Christ.